Praise God. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for our lesson on today. Bless your people with ears so that they can hear and understand. In Jesus' mighty name, amen, amen, and amen. Today, our theme is, what does the Bible say about bullying? What does the Bible say about bullying? And here is a brief song that, since I'm not a singer, I am going to talk us through it, the words. He wakes up haunted with voices in his head. Nobody knows it, but today he won't go unnoticed. He can't forget, can't forgive for what they say. He never been so hurt, but today the screaming is over. Blame the family, blame the bully, blame it on me. Maybe he needed to be wanted. Blame the family, blame the bully. Maybe he needed to be wanted. I just read you the lyrics from the song Bully by the secular band 3 Days Grace. I think this song sends a powerful message about those on the receiving end of bullying. We were not meant to function this way. And it should be no surprise when a victim finally lashes out at the bully. Bullying is very prevalent in today's school, and it is out of control. Does the Bible cover bullying? Well, you won't find the word bully in it, but you will find many stories of people who were bullied, and there are lessons to be learned. Amen? There are two bullies that I want to discuss today. That's Pharaoh and Herodias. But before we go there, I want us to understand a bully left in his own self-defeating manner, grows up to bully his wife and children. For excessive typing purposes, I will refer to the bully as he or him, but there are just as many girls that bully too. Let us dive into scripture and see what the Bible says on this matter. Bullying is a sin. In Micah 6:8 it says, He, God, has told you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you, but to do justice, and to love kindness, and to walk humbly with your God? The bully is someone who enjoys causing other pain and anguish. He does not love kindness, but rather hostility. Therefore, he is in sin. Unless the bully repents of his wrongdoing, he will face a much bigger bully in hell if he dies without accepting Jesus and changing his evil way. We also understand it is a heart issue. The heart of the bully relies on others to back him up. So, we must teach our children not to back up bullies. What's God's view on bullies? In Proverbs 6:16-19, it says, There are 6 things that the Lord hates, 7 that are abomination to him, haughty eyes, a lying tongue, and hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that devises wicked plans, feet that make haste to run to evil, a false witness who breathes out lies, and one who sows discord among brothers. These verses speak about the core of the bully's heart. The bully is proud, haughty. He will lie. He does run something to shed blood. He most definitely devises wicked plans and runs swiftly to do his evil work. The bully usually finds his self-worth in making others feel lower than himself. That is why he keeps bullying. It is a power trip for him. He doesn't realize that God hates the thing he is doing. Why do people bully? To pretend they are tough, to try to get others to like them, to hide their own fears. They copy others who bully. They are unhappy. They don't like who they are. Are there any other reasons? Bullies are big, ugly, loner losers yearning attention. Bullies in the Bible, Pharaoh from the Old Testament. Pharaoh is a perfect example of what a bully looks like. In Exodus chapter 1 shows many things that Pharaoh and his men did to Israel, including dealing shrewdly with them, keeping them slaves, afflicting them with heavy burdens, making them build store cities, made their lives bitter with hard service, and calling the midwives to kill all the newborn boys. The midwives did not obey Pharaoh, thank God. Pharaoh oppressed them because of his power trip. He did not want to lose his dominant status. Of course, we know that God did deliver the Israelites from the hands of Pharaoh and set them free. This is not the case always on earth, but be rest assured, as God says, vengeance is mine and recompense for the time when their foot shall slip. For the day of their calamity is at hand, and their doom comes swiftly. Deuteronomy 32:35. In the end, God will make all things right. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Herodias in the New Testament. In Matthew 14:6-12, we read about Herodias, wife of King Herod, and how she used her own daughter to accomplish her wicked agenda. John the Baptist was very well known in the land. He prepared the way for Jesus to come and baptize many people. He was a threat to Herodias in her mind. So when King Herod gave an oath to give his daughter anything she wanted, Herodias prompted her to ask for the head of John the Baptist. This way, in her mind, she would maintain power through her husband as king. This is bullying to the extreme. How many people do you know that go to the same extremes? Let's learn today to call a spade a spade. Bullying is the spirit of the enemy. And either you're going to cast the spirit out or you are going to move out of the way. The next and last, you would probably have to join them. Amen. Today, the victim's real story. Jamie, sometimes she dreaded so much going to school that she vomited and was too sick to go to school. Sometimes she cried so much that her mother would agree to keep her home for that day and skip school. This wasn't some story she made up to not go to school. Jamie was in great pain emotionally and was suffering with chronic stomach pain, distorted vision, extreme anxiety, and symptoms of depression. All these were due to the fact that she was the victim of bullying. Brandon developed PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder, and depression. After being harassed, tormented, isolated, assaulted, and brutally beaten in our public school system on 12/16/2000, Brandon put a loaded gun to his head, pulled the trigger, and ended his pain. It is just awful to see and hear what bullying does to victims. These are only two precious kids that have been affected. Bullying causes severe physical, psychological, and emotional trauma to victims, as clearly shown in these two examples. As parents, we need to stand up for our kids and do whatever we can to stop others from making victims of our children. Amen. At the heart of the matter, let's compare the heart of the bully against the heart of the Christian. 1. The bully seeks power. 2. The Christian seeks to serve God. 2. The bully wants dominance. 2. The Christian wants to obey God. 3. The bully plans wicked schemes. 3. The Christian plans acts of kindness. 4. The bully acts out in rage. 4. The Christian acts out in love. 5. The bully enjoys inflicting pain on others. 5. The Christian enjoys helping others. 6. The bully hates love and justice. 6. The Christian hates injustice. 7. The bully loves hatred and injustice. 7. The Christian loves justice. 8. The bully relies on others to back him up. 8. Christians need no one but God ultimately. 9. The bully is motivated by self-dominance. 9. The Christian is motivated to encourage and lift others up. Amen. The main thing is that at the heart of the matter, bullies only focus on their own well-being at the cost of others. This sounds a lot like Satan to me. He focuses only on his own wicked scheme to at the cost of anyone he can. The Bible shows us what bullying looks like and how we are to conduct ourselves even in the midst of bullying. But I, Jesus, said to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, so that you may be sons of your Father who is in heaven. For he makes his sun rise on the evil and on the good, and sends rain on the just and on the unjust. Matthew 5:44-45. Friends, we need to stand for what is right by bringing attention to the bully, to the leaders in school. But even more importantly, we need to teach our kids to memorize scripture, pray for their enemies, and understand where their self-worth comes from. I know from personal experience what it's like to be bullied, and it is no fun. But my heart and soul belongs to God, and this is why I am who I am today. If our sons and daughters understand that God is with them in the very hard times, it won't necessarily take the pain of the moment away, but it will encourage them to stay strong and fight the good fight. Rules against bullying. 1. We will not bully others. 2. We will try to help students who are bullied. 3. We will include students who are left out. 4. If we know someone is being bullied, we will tell an adult. Parents, this is what we must instill in our youth today: to help one another against bullying. We must remember what the Bible teaches us: to treat others the way you want to be treated. Amen. And we are going to conclude with our lesson today with an old folks tale dramatization by the Harris Family Youth as they enacted the signifying monkey in their Kwanzaa presentation, December 2014. I pray you enjoy this dramatization as much as I have. Thank you.
I'm sharing with a really special treat. I have to tell you that I grew up with this folk tale. There are folk tales that give us, you know, different ways to learn from different experiences. So let's find out what signifying monkey can teach us from this folk tale. All right. I should introduce everyone, sorry. We have Torin coming up, playing the narrator. We have KJ coming out, playing signifying monkey. We have Autumn coming out, playing the lion. And we have Malcolm coming out, playing the elephant. All right, let's give them a round of applause.
Lion.
You ready?
The lion and the monkey got to talking one day. Monkey looked down and said,
"Lion, I hear you screaming everywhere, and I know someone who does not think that it's true. He told me he could kick the living daylights out."
And lion said,
"Who?
Lion, he talked about your mama, and he talked about your grandma, too. And I'm too polite to tell you what he said about you."
"Who said what? Who?"
A monkey in the tree and lion on the ground. Monkey kept on signifying, but he did not come down.
"His name's Elephant. He's stone sure is not your friend."
"Well, he don't need to be, because today will be his end."
Lion took off through the jungle, lickety-split, meaning to grab Elephant and tear him bit to bit, period. She came across Elephant, popping a righteous nod under a fine, cool, shady tree.
"You owe no good in so-and-so. It's either you or me.
Lion let out a roar and bopped Elephant with her paw. Elephant just took his trunk and busted old Lion's jaw. Lion let out another roar and reared up 6 feet tall. Elephant just kicked her in the belly and left her jaw and paw. Lion rolled over and caught Elephant by the throat. Elephant just shook her loose and butted her like a goat. Then he tromped her, and he stomped her, until the lion yelled,
"Oh no!"
When the elephant let the lion go. Monkey was still setting his tree, when he looked down and said,
"Why, lion, who could that there be?"
"It's me,
the lion." "Lion, you look more dead than alive."
"I want to hear your signifying job."
Monkey kept on signifying.
"Lion, you look like you done had the third degree. Else you've been high on gauge and done got caught in a monkey cage. You ain't no queen to me. In fact, I don't think you can even as much as roar. If you try, I'm liable to get old Elephant to whip your head some more."
Monkey started laughing and jumping up and down. And he jumped so hard that the limb broke. And he went bam on the ground. And his foot slipped that he fell flat down. Lion was on with her front feet and her hind. Lion let the monkey loose to see what his tail could be. And monkey jumped right back up into that tree.
"What I was gonna tell you is, you square old so-and-so, if you mess with me, I'm gonna have an old elephant whip your tail some more."
Said the lion, he's running away. today, monkey doesn't signify in way up out of the way.
May God continue to bless you as you live a life worthy of the calling.